Now I know what you're probably asking yourself. Is Fairy Tail the game to finally break the streak of mediocre RPGs based on anime series? Well, in this video, I'll be answering that question along with whether or not you can enjoy it if you've never watched the show before and what makes Fairy Tail such a pleasant surprise. Let's get started. Now I do want to preface this review by saying I've watched several dozen episodes of the anime and would consider myself a fan. And because of this, some of my opinions might be slightly biased, so this is just something I wanted you to keep in mind throughout this review. Now the story is based on four of the arcs from the anime, including Tenro Island and the Grand Magic Games. Now the crux of the beginning of the game is that you're trying to restore your guild to its former glory. There's been a bit of a time skip and your guild house has gone to shambles and your guild reputation has fallen apart, so you kind of have to build it back up. Now you'll do this by completing quests, delivering items to townsfolk, and upgrading facilities in your guild house. Now I'll dive into each of these features in more detail in just a little bit. Now I feel like Fairy Tail is the perfect fit for a game because that's what the show is all about, just doing quests. And I feel like Gus was the perfect developer because the Atelier games are all about fulfilling short quests, so it kinda goes hand in hand. Now the game is presented in a fun way with some sometimes silly animation. And what's cool is the original voice cast all reprise their roles, adding authenticity for fans of the show. Now I will say the game doesn't go out of its way to introduce you to the characters outside of some short title cards once they first show up. Now there are plenty of opportunities to learn about these characters through small side stories that help flesh out each character, not all that dissimilar from Persona's social link system. Now some of these are very short, like less than a minute, but there are some longer quests. And what's cool about these quests is that it requires certain characters to be in your party, so you'll be mixing and matching characters in ways that you might not normally do, and it's really fun to see how they interact with each other. Now I have to say my favorite character in the show and in the game is Happy. Now Happy isn't actually playable, but rather is Natsu's sidekick. He always makes me smile and is just the perfect mascot character. Now I'll admit that the story is not without its flaws. One of the weirdest things in the game is how it cuts corners. For example, some of the characters like Merity don't have a character model. At first I was kind of confused, I thought they were speaking to characters telepathically, but it seems like they're supposed to be off screen, because they do have a character portrait, there is text on the screen, but it's just really confusing. Now I understand that there's a lot of characters in this game, there's like over a dozen that are playable, so did they just run out of time? And I feel like if you're not a fan of the show or the manga, this will be really confusing because you won't know is this part of their magical ability, what's going on, and so I just wanted to give you that warning for those of you that haven't watched the show. Now if you're not a fan of the show going in, it may take a little time to warm up to the characters, so I definitely recommend doing those side vignettes, but if you are a fan, you'll absolutely love the story. All the characters' personalities shine through as you'd expect, both in the story and through combat. Now as I previously mentioned, one of the main things you'll be doing in the game is quests. Now you'll be moving between a number of locations across the world map, and a lot of these quests mainly consist of collecting a certain number of items or defeating a certain number of enemies. Now the combat is turn-based and you can have up to 5 characters in your party at any given time. And as I mentioned before, there are a lot of characters, so you'll be swapping them out quite a bit. And what's cool is each character has a particular element instead of abilities that enemies are weak to, and that requires you to be a little bit more thoughtful as enemies are lined up over a grid. Now your attacks are performed in a variety of patterns across this grid. These can be anything from straight lines, squares, or even X's. And I have to say, I like this. It kind of made me think instead of just spamming attacks or using my strongest attack. It also made me want to try other characters to see their attack patterns and what abilities they had. Now after a certain amount of time, you'll be able to charge up a move which sets off a chain attack. Now the length and the strength of these chain attacks can increase through character bonds and character ranks, so definitely make sure you're doing everyone's side stories. Now this sounds like it might get repetitive, you do quest after quest, but honestly I found it really addicting. After you complete quests, the rewards feed into other features of the game like upgrading your facilities and your characters, which then makes you want to go back out and do more quests. And I have to admit, I love a good checklist and I might be a little OCD. I had to do every quest that was available and upgrade every facility I could during each chapter. I just had a blast with Fairy Tail's game loop and I was just doing quests for hours on end. And I'd be lying if I didn't say that part of this was to unlock certain costumes. Now I will say that Fairy Tail has a ton of fan service. It really leans into this, especially with a certain beach episode and everybody has a swimsuit costume. Now you don't have to have that on, you can equip whatever costume you want, but I definitely wanted to make sure you were warned in case you're not into that. Now I do want to touch on the environments real quick. Now Fairy Tail is not a big open world game, nor is it like a traditional JRPG where you go town hopping. You mainly stick to a few larger towns which you can explore, but mainly serve as quest hubs. Most of the environments you'll be sent out to do quests are fairly small and pretty linear, similar to ones you might find in an Atelier game. You'll be going to the same environments over and over again, so be prepared for that. Now I think the game has a really great style that really matches the show. The characters look and sound exactly as you'd expect. Now, there are a ton of animations in this game, and that's probably where a large portion of the budget went. There are so many characters, each with a dozen or so unique abilities. The animation team really went to work in this game, but if you don't want to sit through the attack animations every time, you can actually just turn them off. I also have to say that the soundtrack is awesome. The main theme and battle theme get you really excited to go into battle. And I don't know what it is, but there's something oddly compelling about a bagpipe paired with rock guitars. It just works really well together. And the Guildhouse song also is just super jolly. It puts you in a good mood, it's super fun and bouncy, and you can't help but bob your head to it. Now, I do want to touch on a few technical hitches. For starters, the anti-aliasing isn't great even on PS4. The character models and a lot of the environment are a little jaggy around the edges. There are also some noticeable environmental blemishes like pop-in, low-resolution textures, and there are character models that are repeated a lot, sometimes right next to each other. The frame rate also tends to drop during more intense animations or story moments. Now, I did play this on the PS4, but I've seen Switch footage, and if you have the choice, I would really pick up the PS4 version if you can, because the Switch version looks a little rough. It's a little bit more low resolution and just doesn't run as well. In my personal experience, Gus doesn't have a great track record with Switch ports. They aren't really that polished or that optimized. I've had a lot of games in the past crash on me a lot. Now, I'm not saying that Fairy Tail will do that, but I've just had bad experience with Gus games on Switch in the past. So again, if you have the choice, I would pick it up either on PS4 or on PC. All right, now let's answer the questions from the beginning of this video. Is this the first great anime RPG? To be honest, there's still some work to be done, but I was pleasantly surprised at how much fun I was having and how addicted I got to doing quests. Fairy Tail's game loop was right up my alley and I just had a total blast with it. It's probably in the top 5 anime RPGs and is way better than it has any right to be. Now, can you enjoy this if you're not a fan of the manga or the show? I would say yes, but your mileage might vary depending on how much you think you'll enjoy these characters and how much you think you'll enjoy Fairy Tail's game loop. The cast pretty much fulfills all the action anime character tropes you'd expect, and there's really not much more to the gameplay that you haven't already seen in this video. Now, if you can't quite decide, then I might wait for a sale because Fairy Tail certainly isn't for everyone. Now, if you feel like Fairy Tail isn't right for you right now and are just looking for something short to play, then definitely check out my 7 short JRPGs video. There's a bunch of really great games on there that you can beat in 20 hours or less. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe so you can stay up to date with all the latest news, reviews, and other fun videos in the world of Japanese games. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.